Let's now have a look where we want to intrude the upper and lower incisors. And in this situation, we want to maintain the angulation of the lower incisor. And we also want to maintain almost the angulation of the upper incisors, but this angulation could be slightly altered. And we can either tip the apex labially, sorry, or we can retract the whole tooth or tip with controlled tipping the upper incisor. Depends also if we want to have a little bit of retraction. So let's assume for now that we are going to be intruding the lower incisor with pure intrusion. And let's see what kind of mechanical system we can have. So now we know that we want to intrude this tooth along its long axis. We want to avoid any form of proclination. If we use a bracket and a round knot eye wire, let's change the color. This tooth will definitely have some intrusion, but will also tend to procline. So that would be with the straight wire system. We would have to build a different way to control or eliminate this moment as much as possible. So the goal would be to just maintain the intrusion force. One way is to cinch the wire very tightly to try to avoid the force and to try to not let the tooth rotate. Or the second way is to tie the arch very tightly. But another way is to basically not use a straight wire and still put a bracket, use a tube on the molar, maybe with a lingual arch. So the lingual arch is not visible, and use a utility arch that comes from here, goes down to there, comes up here, and comes up here. And we will get also a force that is going to intrude the tooth. You will get an uprighting moment on this molar. And because you're away from the center resistance, you will get also some form of a small moment that will tend to procline the tooth again. One way to minimize the moment of proclination is to again cinch this wire and that should eliminate the forward force or at least reduce it. That's the second way. That would be called with the utility arch. I think Dr. Ricketts have shown many useful application of this in this bioprogressive technique. So this is called the bioprogressive technique. And it works really well for this kind of intrusion. A third method, to be a little bit more, even more precise, would be the segmented approach. So again, a wire here. We put a passive wire in the brackets there. We can also put a lingual arch. And on a secondary tube right here, we can use a cantilever. That will give us a line of action for the force to go right through the long axis of the tooth, which should result in a perfect force. So what we need to do is have a single force that will go right through the center resistance and in the long axis of the tooth. We need to add a small piece of wire to the lower incisors and get the line of action of this force, which is a simple force, to go through the line of action, and we will get a pure intrusion. This system is a bit more complicated, but it's very useful if you really need pure intrusion without any form of proclination of the incisors. How is it built? We use a 0.17 by 25 TMA wire that we can use as a multi-piece wire. And we activate it about, depending on how many teeth we want to intrude, about 20 grams per tooth maximum. So the force is very light, it's constant, and should result in pure intrusion.